What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Jedi Jai. My name is Mike. We got the last episode of season two of Visions. Overall, I've really enjoyed the season, guys. I really thought that every episode had something unique to offer. There's been a unique style to every episode. There have been some common themes, some exploration of the Force and Sith, and there's a lot of spirituality. There's been a lot of sort of, you can tell that there's sort of like cultural differences for each studio in terms of like where they come from in the world, and you know, you've seen different influences overall in the season. But in general, I thought the entire season has been pretty strong, and I think this last episode hopefully will cap it off with something fun. I'm excited to jump in, and let's have some fun. We'll talk about it afterwards. Let's do it. This one's called Ao's Song. I'm not sure how to say that. Ao's Song? Oh, interesting style. Oh, cool. Love the snappy animation. Oh, she has like texture. Cool. So this one has like kind of a stop motion feel to it as well. Or it's just 3D animated with like very good texturing. It's getting hard to tell. Yeah, I think it's just very good texture. Very stereo sound design.
Ooh, she's here.
This is such a
Remember
unique
to keep
style.
Your distance, Ao.
Ao, okay, it is Ao.
This new mineshaft holds some of the darkest blood Kyber I've ever seen.
It might be more corrupt than an old Jedi like me can purify.
Cool.
It's very unstable, very dangerous. Apologies, Kato. My daughter.
You've grown. And so curious.
Cool, man.
They call to you.
I love they make them look like, you know, like dolls.
Ao and I must get to work.
With like a fabric texturing on.
Your Kyber.
Thank you, Abed. We are grateful for your labors. I have some business in town, but perhaps I'll visit the mine later and see the new deposit for myself.
Okay, excellent sound design. Very stereo and...
Ao! This cannot keep happening. Know that to use your voice near the crystal is dangerous. You must learn restraint, Ao. Do you understand?
It's so well animated, too. I love the style. Look at that. Love it.
I'll see you this evening.
Really noticing like the depth of the sound design in this one. I keep mentioning that, but it's noticeable. It's very well done. Dude. Love the environments too.
Wind an extra 10 out of you.
Uh-oh. Dark things down there, dark things. Calling out to her. Oh my goodness. How about a light source, kid? Before descending into dark night. They're all bled. Oh my goodness. Yikes.
Ow. What are you doing here? You need to leave now.
Dude. Dude. There's like a theme this season of kids not listening and almost getting people killed. Dude. Oh, sick, dude. The animation is so well done. She's gonna like sing out. Oh, she just purified every crystal. But now your dad is out of work. No, they're all rich. It's a lot of Kyber.
She purified the Kyber.
Nice.
She purified the Kyber.
How?
Your voice, Al. It is a gift. And I can help you nurture it, but... you would have to come with me.
She's like, your daughter has special powers. May I have her? That's kind of creepy.
We cannot choose where our calling takes us, only whether or not to answer.
I don't know. Just because you're a Jedi.
Consider it. Okay. I'll be leaving in a fortnight.
Okay, at least she's giving her a choice. I guess the Sith lady in episode 2 gave the girl a choice too, as creature's reach.
Ready.
Oh wait, what species are they supposed to be?
I am.
I love the like Tepui feel of it all.
You're the first of our
like
kind to step out into the stars.
Venezuelan almost. Cool ship. Wow, man, such a cool look. Yeah, I feel like that was one of the most unique styles we've seen all season. Like, at first I was like, is this even, it had like a stop motion look, but then it's like clearly CGI and just textured really well. And the environments that they created are so elaborate and beautiful. It was really cool. And the story was actually really good in this one too. I really liked the idea of her purifying the Kyber crystals with her voice. Other than the Kyber itself, I'm not entirely sure. I mean, there was some Star Wars-y things here and there, like some sounds and like droids, and I guess there were a few Star Wars references, but this didn't necessarily feel that Star Wars-y in any way. It was nonetheless really, really cool, and I liked it. I would, like I said, I think this whole season has been pretty strong, and this one fits right in there. This is one of the most unique-looking ones out of the whole bunch, and they did end up kind of having the Jedi use her power in the end there to like stop the rocks. So they've really kept the feel there, I guess. So, I mean, there is a Jedi. It does feel kind of Star Wars in that way, but then I wasn't really even sure, like, is this just a new species we haven't seen before? I wasn't sure what they were supposed to be, but I loved it. I thought it was really good, and I would place it right on par with the other one. So I think that's actually more or less how I feel about this season overall in the whole, is that, like, every episode is pretty good. Every episode has something unique to offer, and every episode, is more or less, you know, they all feel pretty much equal in my eyes. I don't really hold any one episode that much above the other. Some standouts, episode 3 about the sisters, that was a particularly beautiful episode, just not just the visual appeal of it all, but sort of the story behind it, reconnecting with their mother, and it just felt really like the studio that made that had really a passion and a passionate sort of backstory there, and personal, you know, telling something about their culture or whatever. That felt really personal. So I think that episode 3 would probably be the one that I rate the highest. And then, you know, I am your mother, Armin. It was funny seeing that. That was a really unique episode and something that, you know, you never thought you'd get to see, like a Wallace and Gromit style in Star Wars. And one thing I want to reiterate that I keep saying is that, like, since you don't get much time in these episodes, really only working with, like, a 15-minute area of time to, like, do what you can, it would be fun to get something similar where you could really expand on it. Like I mentioned in Season 1, The Ninth Jedi, that episode is one that you could see I would love to see a whole series of episodes of just that one storyline. And there's potential for that in some of this. So whether or not they're going to end up keep giving studios the opportunities to do this, and there might be a Vision Season 3, or they could potentially do a lot of different things. But giving animation studios the opportunity to play in the Star Wars universe is awesome, and I'm so glad we get to do this. I loved it. I'd love to hear what you guys think. Let me know in the comments below what you thought about the whole season. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If you want to see everything unedited, go over to patreon.com/JediDrive and check out the watch-along style reactions there. Anyway, guys, we'll see you in the next reaction. Peace.